Hello students, in this last lecture we have seen some simplest solutions of Friedmann equations. So the Friedmann equation look like this. Okay, I am just writing the first equation. So this is our Friedmann equation, and in this equation you can see that for simplest solutions what we have done, that we have taken k is equal to 0 and solved some simple techniques. But you know that in realistic situations the curvature of universe can be positive, can be negative, it can be a flat universe, so k need not be 0. Okay, so the value of k need not be 0, and it can be k should be plus 1, minus 1, or it can be 0. And basically it corresponds to the positive curvature, negative curvature, and the flat universe. So now there are three possibilities, okay, and you can see that the dynamics of universe for each value, for positive value of k, for negative value of k, and for flat universe will be different. But how to know the curvature of the universe? So the main question is that how to determine curvature of universe. So this is the thing which we will be questioning in today's lecture, that how to determine curvature of the universe. So now curvature is not something which is observable. You can't observe the curvature of the universe, yeah. So it is almost impossible to go, first of all, to find the curvature of the universe, you have to go beyond the universe and you have to see what is the value of curvature coming, and all these things are almost impossible, and you can never do these things. So basically, how, and if you are not knowing the curvature of the universe, then you are not able to solve this Friedmann equation, because to completely solve this Friedmann equation you need the value of k, and for different values of k, for positive k the dynamics will be different, for negative k the dynamics of the universe will be different, and for zero it will be different. So how to move ahead? Okay, so this is the question which we are asking, that how to determine the curvature of the universe. Okay, so there can be some indirect techniques by which we can find the curvature of the universe. Okay, so we are introducing the concept of density parameter. Okay, so see, the equation, the first Friedmann equation was 8 pi g rho by 3 minus k by a square. Okay, so this is the thing, and I am introducing critical density. Okay, critical density is defined as density for which k is equal to 0. Okay, so if I plug in k is equal to 0, then h square is equal to 8 pi g into rho. Now I will write rho with a subscript c, basically this means critical density by 3, and k we have taken 0, so I can write rho c is equal to 3 into h square, okay, by 8 pi g. Okay, so this is an important expression, and always remember that the critical density is a function of time. Why? Because it is directly proportional to h square. So h square, you know, is a parameter of time. It changes with time. Okay, so this is a very important expression for critical density. and you must remember this expression. Okay, so rho c of t is equal to 3h square upon 8 pi g. Okay, so this is the expression for critical density. So rho c of t is nothing but critical density. Okay. Now there is one more parameter, okay, which we can define, which is known as the density parameter. We generally define density parameter with omega, okay, and omega is defined as the density of the universe divided by the critical density. Okay, so since you know that both all these quantities are basically dependent on time, so this is also dependent on time. So basically, let me write it. Rho by rho c. Okay. So this omega of t is written as the density parameter of the universe. Okay. So this is how we define density parameter, which is the ratio of density with density. So if I call this as equation number 1, if I call this as equation number 2, and if I call this as equation number 3, okay, then from equation number 1, you know that h square is equal to 8 pi g into rho by 3 minus k by a square was there. So I can write this now as, okay, so h square is equal to 8 pi g into rho c into omega minus k by a square. How? Basically, I have replaced omega with rho c, rho with rho c into omega. Okay, so I am using equation number 3. Okay, so now I have h square is equal to 8 pi g by 3 into rho c into omega minus k by a square. So we have defined the critical density as rho c is equal to 3 into h square upon 8 pi g. Okay, if you substitute this value in this equation, then you will get h square is equal to h square into omega minus k by a square. So I can write this as omega minus 1 is equal to k upon a square into h square. Okay. So you can now see that from this equation, you can write that your omega minus 1 is proportional to the curvature of the universe. Okay, so this is very important quantity and relation which you have to remember. Okay. Now see, omega is basically a ratio of density of the universe divided by rho c. Okay, so rho is equal to 3, okay, into h square, which is the Hubble parameter, which is an observation parameter, and other all the constants. So basically omega is something which can be observed. Okay, it can be termed as an observational parameter. Now you can see that we have derived the relation that omega minus 1 is proportional to k. Okay, so what it means that if the curvature of universe would be positive, or if I write plus 1, then it implies that omega is always greater than 1. Okay? If k is equal to 0, then you would see that omega would be equal to 1. Okay? And if k is equal to minus 1, then you can say that the value of omega will be between 0 to 1. Okay? So this case is generally known as overcritical density. And this case is known as under critical density. So if you have some idea of omega, the value of omega, if you can determine, then from the value of omega you can determine the curvature of the universe. This kind of universe is generally known as our closed universe. Why we call it closed universe, we will come to it in the next few lectures. And this is known as open universe. And this is something which you know, I can write this as flat universe. So this is a very important relation, and from this relation you can have some idea of the curvature of the universe.